Hello and welcome to our channel of Biodiversity and Conservation by Ambika Prasad Research Foundation. So today in this video we are introducing Ambika Prasad Research Foundation or APRF. There is always being a question that what is the work of Ambika Prasad Research Foundation? What is the aim? What is the main motto of Ambika Prasad Research Foundation? What we are doing? You have seen that we are littering in field, in forest, but what is the work, main work? We are talking about many plants, we are talking about medicinal plants, we are talking about their secondary metabolites, we are interacting with local people, but what is the main aim? Will our work really help our society? Will this work will really help to conserve our biodiversity, or will our work help to revive our culture again? So let's check out what APRF is working on.
My grandmother used to let me take the steam of Thylophora indica if in case I had cold or cough or respiratory problems. But nowadays, you can hardly find people taking such traditional therapeutic systems. So nowadays, people prefer fast and immediate action without considering much of the side effects. There are so many traditional therapeutic systems that have been passed down from our forefathers. So APRF is actually collecting those informations from different regions. But the problem is that some people might be telling the truth while others might be lying. So we are validating those claims that they have made scientifically.
Human civilization, our culture, our tradition, knowledge, the customs, the laws we have has totally interlinked and intertwined with our scientific advancement. So the lifestyle we are living is totally different from the lifestyle our ancestors have built. So this lifestyle, the changes in this lifestyle influenced our environment, our health, our society, our ecosystem, everything. So the current scenario is that the scientific community is now not interactive with the common people. Though the culture or the tradition we have is the inseparable part of the growing scientific world. So the different cultures, different traditions we have all over the world, they have lots of hidden treasure of knowledge and information from that the scientific world can extract. So we are trying to identify the interconnection and trying to build a bridge between the scientific world and the common people.
Out of all landscape, do you know wetland act as a kidney? Well, how? They filter harmful materials and release clean water to the lakes, rivers and other water bodies. Well, do we really see wetland as a productive ecosystem? Well, I don't think so. Because from the survey and from the information collected from people, we get to know that people use it as dumping sites or waste areas, or maybe it used as an urbanization area. So we are here to make you aware of the wetland, how it is important and how it's benefit to us. Let's see what wetland do for us. It has a rich biodiversity from microbes to mammals. It controls floods and it acts as a natural sponge from storm destruction, and it is also relief from the heat stress to the wildlife. And so in APRF we are making you aware of the wetland and how to conserve it, and also making you aware of the wetland flora and its important.
Have you ever thought why plants are so important to us? Basically, they are the primary producers, and they are directly or indirectly related to any species on this earth. Do you know that elephant conservation is equivalent to the forest conservation? Do you know that tiger conservation conservation is equivalent to water conservation? Do you know that the conservation of bee is equivalent to human existence? Yes, we are working on this delicate relationship between flora, fauna and the coexisting environment.
So do you know, plant plays an important role to monitor or to indicate the status of the environment. There exist many plants in our ecosystem which are the indicator of our environment. So we call it as bioindicator. So for example, we can take Lipia javanica. Lipia javanica is a plant which indicates the presence of water around like 200 meters. We can take the example of carnivorous plant like Urticularia species, which can indicate the pollution in water or the pH of the water, the acidity of the water. So you can join us to identify such interesting bioindicators.
It is not new that the environment is degrading, polluting, whether it is air or water or soil. So you know the reason why also. It's because of the dust, it is because of the smoke and the chemical fertilizers. It's a long list to go. So what we do is we try to find out natural ways to reduce such pollutants. If you see plants like Alstonia scolaris, if you can see Cassia fistula, if you can see Pongamia pinnata, they help to absorb dust from the air. On the other hand, if you see plants like Syzygium cumini, the bark of the Syzygium cumini can actually absorb heavy metals like chromium. And species like Lamna species, they help to reduce the pollutants in water. So these are some of the characters of the plants. They can actually contribute to the positive environment. So we try to research on the characters of the plant so it can help to reduce the pollutant of the environment.
So we are talking a lot about conservation. Even everyone is talking about the conservation of our floral wealth, of our faunal wealth. But we have no language to communicate with our floral wealth or to our faunal wealth. But we humans are very intelligent. We can study them. We can study the behavior of the plant or any faunal species. If we want to conserve a plant species, then we have to study first their habitat, their soil quality, their environment in which they are growing. So, and if we want to conserve a faunal species, then we have to study their fooding behavior, their breeding behavior, the species and the food which they are taking before breeding, after breeding, what are their habitat. So this leads to a better conservation of our floral and faunal wealth. So APIF works on surveying the behavior of floral and faunal species and their associated taxa.
The outcome of all the research that we have talked about is incomplete if we do not go to field, if we cannot identify plants, and if we do not interact with people. So focusing on the grassroots level of the research is the base of the works of APRF. So this includes creating field botanies and then taxonomies, ethnobotanies. So identifying plants as a taxonomies is the key. But do you notice that the students nowadays, they are least interested in taking taxonomy as your subject? Yes. It happens. In general, students, they prefer taking molecular biology, genetics, biotechnology, and then biochemistry. The list is endless. But working with APRF, we have a platform where all the students, they come, start from the field work, and then they get the opportunity to touch all the aspects of this biological sciences in one platform. Thank you for watching.